Now, Mauryan administration. Mauryan administration can be divided into four divisions: central, provincial, district, and village. The administration of the city of Pataliputra was separate. First of all, let us discuss central administration. The king was the highest authority of the central administration. He took all important decisions related to the empire. He was assisted by a council of ministers. They acted as the king's advisors. The various branches of administration, that is, revenue, trade, welfare, army, etc., were governed by the officers called amatyas. Next is provincial administration. The empire was divided into provinces, each headed by a royal prince, Kumara. He ruled the province as king's representative and was helped by many officers, Mahamatyas, and council of ministers. From Ashokan edicts, it is known that the Mauryan Empire was divided into four provinces with their capitals at Toshali, Ujjain, Suvarnagiri, and Takshila. Next is district administration. These provinces were further divided into districts. The Pradeshtha was the head of the district. He was aided by Yuktas and the Rajukas, who surveyed and assessed the land, collected taxes, and maintained law and order. Next is village. A cluster of villages made up one district. Villagers helped government officials in marking the village boundaries, maintaining land records, and collecting taxes. Each village had a headman who was chosen by the villagers themselves and was assisted by a council. Now, administration of Pataliputra. Pataliputra was the capital of the empire. It was surrounded by a wooden wall which had 64 gates and 570 towers. There was also a moat around the city to protect it from enemy attacks. A committee of 30 members oversaw the administration of the city. This committee was divided into six boards, each comprising five members. Each board looked after a specific department, such as comfort and security of foreigners, registration of births and deaths, inspection of manufactured goods, collection of taxes. Now, army. The Mauryan kings maintained a large and regular army. The soldiers were well equipped and well paid. The army was divided into six divisions: horse soldiers, chariot soldiers, elephant soldiers, foot soldiers, transport, and navy. There was also a very efficient spy system, having large number of spies, many of whom were women. These spies were stationed at different parts of the kingdom and kept the king informed of all the developments within and outside the extent of the kingdom. The Senapati commanded the army, though during wars the king himself led his army. The soldiers were equipped with bows and arrows, swords, armors, and shields. All military equipment was looked after by a separate department. According to Megasthenes, the Mauryan army under Chandragupta comprised of 6 lakhs infantry, 30 cavalry, 9,000 war elephants, and 800 chariots. The army was regularly trained and well paid.